Okay, well, this is the project. I'm going to present this project that Dr. Cheng and I started doing last year when I was a visiting professor at the University of Salamanca. I come from Monterrey, Mexico, Tecnológico de Monterrey. And this is the first attempt that we're doing in analyzing intercultural communication competencies related to the use of computer-mediated communication using networks and internet in general. So this is an exploratory study. It's called, it's a small world after all, and we tried to, we intended to map intercultural competence in computer-mediated communication users. So why did we decide to do this study? Well, first, because we know that the perception of apparent one-world closeness among inhabitants living in this planet by means of effective advanced information communication technologies was something that was ticking us. And secondly, the development of theories on the use of computer-mediated communication technologies in the last 10 years, which are pointing to assume that people nowadays are more actively engaged in being connected to boundaryless networks by these means, using the internet. And thirdly, because internet has become a tool for young people, especially from different places and cultures, to create and maintain a borderless virtual community. Those were some of the things that caught our attention, and we decided to start working on this project, which is the first one of some others that we have in mind. So our study aims at examining the internet users' intercultural communication competence by means of two things. First, exploring the developmental stage of intercultural awareness in social network users among college students in Spain. And secondly, we are going to map the perception of cultural others or ethnic minorities. What we did for this first attempt in our study is a survey that was conducted with university students who responded to a questionnaire designed for this study purpose consisting of three indexes. The first one is the intercultural communication competence. The second one is the index, the CNC index, which is which rates participants' habit of accessing to computer-mediated communication, such as social networks and navigation on the internet. And the third one was a developmental model of intercultural sensitivity that tests participants' degree of denial versus acceptance of cultural differences. So briefly, who participated? We had almost 400 students who attend the university here in Salamanca. 32% were male and almost 59% were female. So in this slide, we will see the X represents the variable rejection versus acceptance of immigrant status as foreigners. And the XY represents the index participants' habit of computer-mediated communication use. So with the aid of these two axes, the graphic of intercultural competence map was able to organize into four areas. And the ones that we have, as you can see, is A, B, C, and D. So, what I'm going to explain now is that in the first quadrant that we have, the A, represents the model of intercultural sensitivity stage area of high CMC users who deny immigrants to be considered foreigners. And then we have on the quadrant B which represents the model of intercultural sensitivity stage area of high computer-mediated communication users who accept immigrants to be regarded as foreigners over there, which I'll explain something that we found interesting there. Then we move to the quadrant C, represents the model of intercultural communication sensitivity stage area of low CMC users who deny immigrants to be considered foreigners. And finally, the last quadrant, D, represents the model of intercultural sensitivity stage area of low CMC users who accept immigrants to be regarded as foreigners. And one of the things that we found, if you notice, the dimensions, for example, the quadrant D is the one who has the most intercultural competence dimension. And what does this all mean? And what we found is that on an overall observation, the Spanish college students participating in this survey scored rather high intercultural sensitivity towards those ideas related to social desirability or political correctness. And it may not be, for example, true that they hold that, but it's politically correct to say that, everybody is. But this outcome is not surprising, since it is considered that students from rather open-minded academic atmospheres in most public universities here in the European Union are probably more aware of their liberal or progressist ego than other citizens. However, this condition does not necessarily mean that they effectively acquire particular intercultural communication competencies. Therefore, when asked about their intercultural communication skills, such as nonverbal awareness or adjustment of their own behaviors to suit in unfamiliar cultural environments, the responses evidence their low awareness of certain aspects of communication competence needed in an intercultural encounter. And let's see. Survey respondents with moderate habit in using CMC social networks but highly accept an equal consideration for immigrants and foreigners tend to fall into the area of empathy and predisposition dimensions, which we have them. Where are we?
Green.
Empathy. Yeah, the green one.
Yes.
Okay. Which are defined as being cognitively thoughtful, effectively considerate, behaviorally capable of putting oneself or themselves in other shoes, holding positive attitudes and willingness to interact with cultural others. On the other hand, those participants with high frequency in access to CMC social networks are more reluctant to accept immigrants to be considered equal to foreigners are associated to the ethnocentrism area, which is the first quadrant, characterized by conservativeness and universalistic worldview dimensions. This means when they are conservative, they are defined as having intolerance towards ambiguity or different worldviews, and universalism is viewed as ethnocentricity, oriented to the view of the world as one according to one's cultural values or beliefs, which is over there. If you are ethnocentric, well, according to the theory, you fall into that quadrant. And it is interesting to observe that moderate use of CMC social networks in participants with ambiguous attitudes, denial, acceptance towards immigrant as equal for foreigners, seem to position themselves within a fifth stage that we put in the middle. And this fifth stage area is located in the very center of the graphic, constituted by three intercultural communication dimensions, which are acceptance of cultural difference, non-verbal communication awareness, and intuitive understanding. So these three dimensions are directly related to intercultural communication skills and are positioned in a seemingly non-defined area. It's like all the quadrants, they fall in the middle. So what we think, or what we conclude, is that this finding represents an interesting area for researchers for their explore processes of meaning negotiation and culture mediation in relation with changing attitudes towards cultural minorities. And this is what we have. Okay, that's it. I didn't want you to read. Just... Okay.